Mrs Dalloway is a novel where we really have a kind of a trip through the whole life experience of the central character. It's all set around the eve of an important party, and all kinds of strands in her life sort of feed into that moment. So she's busy, there's a lot of stuff happening, and she has some encounters with people from her past. Also, there's a whole sort of imaginative kind of recap of various events. It's also about the city in a way. It's about the choices she has made to get us to where, you know, to get her where she is, and also the choices she didn't make. So it's a really rich sort of reading experience. Flowers of Herself, in a way, is it's her sort of literally going out and getting flowers, you know. She decides to get the flowers herself. And it's about her being in the streets. And it's about the energy of her sort of going through this sort of bustling city. And it has this perpetual motion in it. And the way that piece is structured is, it's a little bit like, you know, if you're walking down the street, you'll see a bus and then you'll see another bus in a different place. So there's this kind of shifting of perspectives. And in a way, it's almost like there are atoms of material in that music, and I keep throwing the dice and shuffling them around. A sort of perpetually moving, high-speed Hall of Mirrors. It's kind of a workout for the band, actually. The orchestra really sweat in that piece, which I think they quite like doing, because it, you know, it's really hard. It's really, really hard. And there is that sort of feeling of an energy of an orchestra when it's working hard, when it's kind of bustling, if you like that city is bustling. You know, you get a kind of a, you know, it's a sort of, it's quite an excitement, I think, in the orchestra.